I think that as the elites and these, you know, these intersectional people start squeezing the white working classes even more and more than what they are already doing, stamping them down, you know, with their boot heel on their necks, I think it's inevitable. I think that there will be a rebellion. And I think that a lot of fair-minded people are going to start siding with the white working class people. And I think that we are headed into a civil war. And I think that this incident in Christchurch, if there are more like it that come from disenfranchised young men who feel that there is no hope, that their lives are meaningless, and that any opportunity, any goodness in their lives has been taken away from them by this insane ideology, well, I think that there will be more violence. And there will be a lot more incidents like this. And it will target not only Muslims, but also other quote-unquote people of color, as well as feminists. And we have seen this over the years, just little hints of this. The Oklahoma City bombing in 94, or 95 was it? We have seen little eruptions. There's something about Christchurch that feels different, as if a tipping point had been reached, as if the man who committed this murder, this atrocity, is giving tacit permission to others like him to follow in his lead. That's why I do believe that there will be more incidents like Christchurch. And I think that more and more young men are going to start organizing, because I think that they are going to begin to recognize that they have no hope. And the only hope that they have for any kind of future for themselves is to rebel against their annihilation. Because it has to be understood, you see, there is a side of the population in the Western democracies that truly and openly and articulately wants the destruction of these disenfranchised young men. They want them gone. And so if somebody wants you gone, what do? If you can't go anywhere, well, you fight.